Hello everyone, Star here. I have a gameplay for you today as the Gunslinger Engineer on King of the Hill Badlands. And my opinion on Gunslinger Engineers is, if you're playing King of the Hill, they're probably one of the best choices you can make. Heavies are a really awesome choice, but for overall just like defending areas and annoying people, I don't know, Gunslinger Engineer works out so well because your mini sentries placement never becomes irrelevant like it would in a payload map, where you need to constantly keep moving it up and keep being aggressive with it. On King of the Hill, you can just plop it down in one place. It's probably going to get kills, and that's really all there is to it. And on this map, it's so perfect because there is so much open area. They're pretty much obligated to get in the range of it. I had it over there in a really good spot. I destroyed it half to get these crits right here, and half because that is also another great spot for it. But I would say pretty much any spot for a mini sentry on this map is a good one, as long as it's near the middle. And kabloom! I walked over a pipe bomb. Kind of dumb, but I was in a hurry to get to that health because I was burning. So I died. Going to point out, that is the only time I die in this video, I think. Which brings up the point that I think Gunslinger Engineer is probably one of the easiest, I don't know if easy is the right word, but for me it's the most casual class selection I can make on any King of the Hill map, where I feel like I consistently do very, very well as a Gunslinger NG on King of the Hill, because it is such a powerful class selection for what you have to do on this map, especially if your team is capable of getting the point, because then you can set your sentry up in much better spots. Like right here, I kind of wish I would have destroyed my sentry and placed it up on their little balcony. That is a really nice spot for it as well, because people are like, that pyro down there was obviously going to walk across. It would have killed the scout, a whole bunch of other stuff, but I retreat to it and have all this open area. You can see it's killing that soldier from all the way over there. It has such a nice range on this map, where, you know, pretty much wherever you do place it, it's lined up to annoy somebody somewhere. I didn't really tend to my teleporters, dispensers this round, because I didn't feel like I had the time to do it. We were doing very well. Teleporter's not very important on King of the Hill in the first place, and that dispenser, didn't really think of a good spot to place it. Probably should have put it behind one of the train carts near the point. That's a pretty good spot, but I didn't, so in the future, I'm probably going to be doing that instead. Bam! That was nice. Just explodes as he turns a corner. Gotta use those crits wisely. As you saw before, I did opt to punch that sniper in the back rather than waste my crit on him, which is also the reason why I use a pistol rather than the Wrangler. Also, just hate the Wrangler. That's about it. That pyro as well. That's how you make pyros look dumb. Just walk away, let him into my mini sentry. Keeps following me. Don't know why pyros do that. Don't do that, kids. Grown-ups. Whatever you are, don't do it. I don't care if you're a leprechaun. And this round is already pretty much over. We really held it pretty well on this map. This particular round, we held it very well, just trying to get my sentry in here for some last few pickings on these people if they try and capture the point, and they cannot really hold a solid push. It was their last attempt to grab it, and they could not do so. One more guy running in. Hope you enjoyed this video. Coming to a close now, top scoring. And that's about it. So, catch you guys later.